Hi, welcome. This is Clemens at Elektor. In this video, we will talk a bit about Arduino, what exactly it is, and how to get started with it. It was in 2008 that I first learned about Arduino. The famous Arduino Uno board did not exist yet. The top board then was the Arduino J6000, which had an 80 Mega 168 microcontroller from Atmel on it. At first, I thought that Arduino was simply a small microcontroller board, but delving deeper, I discovered that it consisted of three things: a low-cost microcontroller board, a bootloader, and a simplified programming environment. Combined, these three things suddenly made using a microcontroller easy without requiring special and complicated tools. If, like me in the pre-Arduino days, you spent many hours on setting up expensive commercial toolchains for microcontroller development, you will understand that I was immediately hooked. Also, because everything is simple, open source and free, it is easy to make your own Arduino compatible board. This is the first Arduino compatible board that I built. Basically, it's nothing more than a microcontroller with a voltage regulator and an extension connector. It is Arduino compatible, however, because I programmed the microcontroller with the Arduino bootloader. It needs a USB to serial adapter to program it. All Arduino boards with a USB connector have this adapter on board. Summarizing, an Arduino compatible board is nothing more than a microcontroller with a bootloader inside, some extension connectors, a power supply and a programming adapter. And actually, besides the microcontroller, everything else is optional. The bootloader plays an important role in the Arduino concept. It is a small piece of software inside the microcontroller that provides an easy way of loading new programs into the controller. Instead of requiring a special, usually expensive programmer, the bootloader lets you upload programs over a serial port. Because computers today don't have serial ports anymore, a USB to serial adapter is needed. By adding an adapter to the microcontroller board, this obstacle disappears, even though it does make the board a bit more expensive. Unless you have the intention to build your own Arduino compatible boards, you can forget about the bootloader. A special program is needed on the computer to communicate with the board. This is handled by the third pillar of Arduino, the IDE, where IDE stands for Integrated Development Environment. The IDE lets you write programs and upload them to your Arduino compatible board by simply clicking a button. Compared to professional microcontroller development environments, the Arduino IDE is extremely simple. It is also much less powerful, but it has everything you need to create cool microcontroller applications. It can be so simple because the IDE has a library of easy-to-use functions that hide all the difficult stuff from the user. Thanks to these built-in libraries, there is hardly any need to know how the microcontroller works. Instead of figuring out how to make, for instance, a pin 15 switch on or off, you just use the function digitalWrite on pin 15 and specify its value. Reading a voltage is as easy. No need to read the microcontroller's datasheet to learn how to configure its analog-to-digital converter. Simply use the function analogRead with the pin that accepts analog signals. Not only do the libraries hide the internal complexities of the microcontroller, they also simplify writing programs by providing powerful, high-level functions that allow you to concentrate on your application instead of first having to build everything from the ground up. Note that in the Arduino world, a program is called a sketch. So now that you know what Arduino is, how do you get started? It starts by getting an Arduino-compatible board. For newbies, I highly recommend the Arduino Uno R3. There are many clones of this board available that are cheaper than the official Uno, but try to at least start with an official Uno board. Not only will this guarantee full compatibility with the software tools, it also helps sustaining the Arduino team that makes all this stuff available for free. You will also need the Arduino IDE to program your board. Currently, there are three options. 1. Using the online web editor. 2. The classic IDE on your computer. And 3. Arduino Pro. The third option is intended for advanced users, so I will not go into that. If you want to see what it looks like, check out this video. To get the classic or web IDE, you have to go to www.arduino.cc. There's a lot of stuff going on there, but you can ignore it all. Just click Software from the menu bar and then click Downloads. A new page opens that starts with the Arduino Web Editor. As it is the first option, we will start there. Note that the web editor is part of the Arduino Create platform. Since we have never done this before, we first create an account. This is nothing special, so I skip it here. The next step is to install a browser plugin that allows the web editor to communicate with the Arduino board. First download it, then install it. If for some reason the installation of the plugin took too long and the web page timed out, click the Try Again button. Once the plugin is recognized, we can move on to the web editor. Now connect your Arduino board to the computer. If all is well, it is detected automatically by the web editor. Open the LED blink example to verify that you can indeed upload a program to the board. Note that you don't have to connect an LED to the board as there is already one on it. After successfully uploading the sketch, the onboard LED should blink at 0.5 Hz. As a first step, as a software developer, try to change the blink rate of the LED. As soon as you start editing the example, the web editor will ask you to save a copy of the sketch, as examples are read-only. Change the two delay commands and upload the sketch to your board. The blink rate should now be as you specified. That's it for the web editor. Now let's do the same thing for the classic offline IDE. First, download and install the latest version suitable for your computer. If you can, download the Windows installer. The advantage of the installer over the other versions is that it will also install the drivers needed to communicate with the board. On other platforms, you may have to install the drivers yourself. Note that the drivers are included in the download. The non-installer versions offer more control over the installation. It is, for instance, possible to install the IDE on a USB stick. After installing the IDE, open it. Unlike the web editor, the classic IDE is not capable of detecting your board automatically, so you must tell the IDE which type of board it is and to which port it is connected. The default board is the Uno. Click the port entry to select the port. To make this work, the board must be connected to the computer. Now, from the File menu, select Examples, then Basics, and then Blink. This is the same example as we used earlier in the web editor. Click the Upload button to write the sketch to the board. The onboard LED should start blinking at 0.5 Hz. Change the two delay commands to modify the blink rate and upload the sketch once again to your board. The blink rate should now be as you specified. Alright, that's it. You are now ready to start exploring Arduino and create cool microcontroller applications in an easy way, either with the online web editor or with the offline classic editor. The offline editor is a little bit faster, but the advantage of the online editor is that it is always up to date. Use whatever you prefer. Okay, that's it. I hope you found it interesting. Please don't forget to subscribe to our channel and tap or click the bell button. Thank you for watching.